Welcome. Today's video is on construction management and entrepreneurship module 1, some numericals related to management subject. So the numericals are related to network diagrams and port and CPM. We have to prepare a network diagram. We are going to prepare the critical path method, then we are going to prepare the PERT, that is performance evaluation research techniques. So in this we are going to do some numericals as per the syllabus which is there. So let us see the first numerical. The first numerical question: the activity data of a project is given in table below. Activity, preceding activities, duration in days. They are asking us to draw the network diagram. Also, they are asking us to identify the critical path and total project duration using critical path method. So, activity X is having 5 days of duration. Activity Y is preceded by X activity with a duration of 2. Activity C is having 6 days of duration, activity D is having 4 days of duration, activity E is having 7 days of duration with preceding D activity, and finally F activity is having 3 preceding activities Y, C, E, and duration is 3. So now let us look into the solution of this. We are going to prepare a arrow or node activity. So first, the node activity, how we are going to prepare is, node activity is given in this format. A node is prepared, between the activity is shown arrow mark and another node. So we can say this is first node, this is second node. Activity we are able to write it here, and durations we are writing here. This is activity, node activity, and arrow activity. So activity based on the arrow, that is we can call it as arrow activity, node will be present. We are provided with the activity and durations, and we have to connect the nodes. In this numerical, we have to follow with the arrow activity. In this, the activity is provided and duration is provided. So going to the solution part, now we need to think how to prepare the particular network diagram. Network diagram, we have to choose the first part, such as which activity is first. So now we are having X activity first. So we will be drawing the activity of X. This is X activity. When we are drawing the activity arrow, we will be able to get two nodes, node 1 and second node. Now this node is there, we can get this activity X. Now which is next activity? Y activity, which is having X as the preceding activity. Preceding activity means the behind activity. This is the further activity and this is back activity. So we will follow the activity as Y. Now this is Y activity. Now we will be able to get one more node at this moment, right? It is. Now we have to see which is the activity. We are able to get the C activity. C activity is here. After that we are able to have the directly F activity, because C is, F is preceded by C activity. Now we have to check that whether Y activity is also preceded by F activity. Yes, Y activity, F activity is preceded by Y activity, means after Y we are going to draw the F activity. We will get one more node at this moment, and this is F activity. So this is the basic part of networking. Still some nodes we have, activities we have left, such as C activity, D activity and E activity. We are going to draw them. Now we can see C activity is there. There is no preceding activity for C activity. There is no preceding activity for C activity means we have to draw it from the start. We are taking it from the starting point itself only. Now when we are starting it from this, so C is presiding for which activity? F activity. F activity is here. So C activity is this one and it is presiding to F activity as we can see it this part. And now next activity is D activity, which is having activity ahead D is E activity. So again D activity is starting from the start point. We have to take it from the start point only. It is D activity. Then from D activity it is E activity. Now we can see E activity is again as a preceding activity for F activity. So F activity, we will be able to get the E activity here. So we can say this is E activity. Now when we see it into the activity based, we have completed activity and preceding activity into network form. Let us put the numericals for the nodes 1, 2, 3, 4. I will put it in this way. And I will put it this way as the 5. Just a moment, I have made a small correction. I will make it. So this part I have to take. Second, this is third node, this is fourth node, and this is fifth node. Correct? So we got this as the networking diagram. Now I am writing the durations 5, Y activity 2, D activity, C activity is having 6. Below I am writing D activity is 4. E activity is 7, F activity is 3. These are the activities and the durations. Now I am going to make something different part, that is the boxes I am going to create near the nodes. That boxes are having early start time and late start time. These are the two boxes which will be showing you early start time and late start time, by which we can easily draw the critical path method. We can prepare the critical path method in simple format. Exactly. Now let us move for the calculation part, which is the most important part in this now. So here the early start time is 0, clear? So I am going to take with early start time first, and this is late start time, and this will be early finish time and this will be late finish time. So in between the activity will be counted. So in this one condition we have to choose, that is when we are putting in going ahead moment, the maximum value we have to take, and when we are going to come back we have to choose the minimum value. So let us go with the maximum value. This is one node, second node. 0 plus 5 we will get it as 5, 0 plus 4 we will get it as here 4. Now next we are able to get 5 plus 2, 7 is here. Also 4 plus 7 we will get 11, and from 0 plus 6 we are able to get 6. So which is maximum? We can see once again 0 plus 6 is 6. No, we are not going to take this one. 5 plus 2, we are going to get 7. No, we are not going to take this. 4 plus 7, we are able to get 11. So, maximum 1, 11 is there. I'll put it here, 11. 11 plus 3, 14. So, early finish time will be also 14 and late finish time will also be 14. Now, when I going to come back in return moment, that is 14 minus 3, this is 11. Now, again, 11 minus 6, this will be 5. I will not take this. 11 minus 2, here I have no choice. I have to write 11 minus 2 is going to be 9. And 11 minus 7, I am going to get it as 4. 9 minus 5, 4. I will not write it here. The minimum one I have to write, because you can see once again, 11 minus 6 tracking. So, it is 5 we are getting. 9 minus 5, we are getting 4. And here at the bottom, third node, 4 minus 4, I am going to get 0. The minimum one is 0, so I will write it 0. Now we can see some values which are same as equal. 0, 0, 4, 4, 11, 11, 14, 14. So wherever this equal values we are getting on the node, this will become our critical path. This will be the critical path. This is the critical path. So, total duration is 14 and critical path is 1, 3, 4, 5. I will write it here. Total duration of the project is equals to 14 days and using CPM, that is critical path method, critical path method. In critical path method, which were the nodes, I will write it 1, 3, 4, 5. These are the nodes wherein we get this as the critical path. So, this is about the numerical number 1.